Greetings. This video addresses the third point raised by Muslim poster The Jedi. Jesus never said he was the Son of God. Why don't you get about the business of living the life of Jesus instead of obsessing on him being God or his Son? It is not my goal to embarrass you, brother, but Islam has made you ignore facts that are all too easily found. You declare, rather emphatically, that Jesus never said he was the Son of God. Allow me to show you just how wrong the teachers of Islam are when it comes to clear truth. John 10:36. Then what about the one whom the Father sanctified and sent into the world? How then can you accuse me of blasphemy? This is Jesus talking. How then can you accuse me of blasphemy for stating that I am the Son of God? This is Jesus talking, and he's arguing with the Jews, and they're accusing him of blasphemy. How then can you accuse me of blasphemy for stating, for saying that I am the Son of God? You see, brother, Jesus said those very words. I am the Son of God. And the poor fool who taught you probably was taught by another ignorant fool. And not one man in Islam cares about the simple act of checking the things they are told. That may sound harsh, brother, but you now face a dilemma. You can accept, brother, that Jesus said those very words, I am the Son of God. Or you can cling to the error and lie that Islam has taught you. Why don't you get about the business of living the life of Jesus instead of obsessing on him being God or his Son? Islam commands you to wage jihad and apply dua to spread Islam. The dua includes willful deception called taqiyya. Don't you think that Christians who actually have the truth should share the truth of God? This is the gospel of Jesus Christ, to share his good news. Christians must not worry or fear that Satan wages jihad against them at every turn in these last days. In fact, I refuse to stand before God with your blood on my hands. The gospel, brother, is the truth revealed by the prophets and fulfilled by Messiah's death on the cross. As we discussed in part 2, this plan is a mystery to you who think Shahada alone washes away sins. The message of the prophets is the key, brother, and Satan's jihad against the truth is to claim their message was lost and changed. But the message of the prophets exists and has been preserved, and it is available for you to read if you respect God, your Creator. But make no mistake, while the truth is free, it will cost you your life. You must choose the truth over father, mother, family, friends, job, and even your life. Those in Islam that truly follow Muhammad's Quran must kill you if you leave submission to Muhammad's stories for the truth, for a true path to the God of Abraham. Obsessing on him being God or his Son. Brother, pursuit of God and the knowledge of God and the truth of God is the highest pursuit in this life. God has revealed himself by the prophets, and we should learn their message if we respect God. Understanding God's message is the proof we have learned his message. We do not just repeat syllables in a foreign tongue. There is no alif lam mim in the message of the prophets in the message from God. The question about Jesus being the Son of God or being God himself is a question God opened in his revelation of himself. As already proven in this video, Jesus said, "I am the Son of God." But Jesus did not stop there with what he said. And it is out of respect for Almighty God that we study to understand the things Jesus said. But more than what Jesus said, the prophets said things that imply Jesus is Yahweh God come in the flesh. You see, brother, any man may come and make claims. A man may claim he and he alone speaks for Allah. A man may claim his words are not his, but are the words of some Allah. A man may claim he is foretold in other holy scriptures. A man may claim he is the seal of the prophets, and no one may correct or change his words. So, while a false prophet may make any claim about himself, Jesus is proven to be God by what the prophets of God said about him. It is a limited human mind, crippled by a stunted thinking process, that refuses to consider all the prophets revealed, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.